have given us all the only shine we've ever had in our life would take. Thank you for protecting us as children, and I ask you to guide us as adults. In your precious and holy name, amen.
Welcome to the 2022 Baybridge High School Baccalaureate Ceremony. My name is Lawson Murray, and I'm an honor graduate for the Baybridge High School Class of 2022. It was an honor to be asked to give the welcome for this ceremony. As I stand before you today, I am in awe and admiration of our class's accomplishments over our academic career. As Psalm 24
the members of the Dade County Board of Education, Superintendent Mr. Tim Cochran, Principal Mr. Chris Merritt, faculty, staff of Bainbridge High School, parents, guardians, but most of all, the graduating class of 2022. It is a great pleasure and honor for me to be able to speak to you today on this evening regarding the future path that each of you will take. My focus topic today is based on you being in control, going to captivity or bondage, to the wilderness, and then to the promised land. First of all, let's take a few minutes to turn back the hands of time. Let us review what has happened in your life up to this present time. When you were born, you decided on how you wanted your parents to care for you. The main strategy that you used to manipulate your parents was crying. Every time you cried, your parents were on a rampage to try to find out what was wrong or what did you need. They were searching to find out what did they need to do to satisfy you and keep you from crying. They wondered, are you hungry? Do I need to change your diaper? Do you want me to rock you? It didn't take you long to figure out that you were in control. Whenever you took a nap, everyone in the household walked on eggshells to make sure you weren't disturbed while sleeping. As you grew older and hit the terrific twos, you realized you hadn't made and you were just holding your parents hostage. Well, as you continued to grow and reach the age of four, things began to change. Those parents that you were holding hostage had transformed into pharaohs. When it was time for you to go to school, you no longer had the luxury of sleeping late in the morning. All of a sudden, the words accountability, responsibility, and work ethics became a major part of your routine. More pharaohs were added to the mix called teachers and administrators when you arrived at school. They began to enforce greater demands on you. They called them grades, tests, assessment, promotion and retention policies, and then most of all, honor. All the freedoms you once had began to look like bondage and captivity. At the end of your elementary year, God told Moses to tell those pharaohs, which were your teachers and administrators, to let my people go. When you entered middle school and began extracurricular activities, along with your regular school work, more pharaohs came on the scene, called coaches, class sponsors. They added to this captivity as well. These pharaohs added more and more requirements and demanded more self-discipline and respect from each activity that you were involved in. At the end of the middle school years, God told Moses to tell the middle school teachers, coaches, club sponsors, and administrators to let my people go. Captivity and bondage didn't get any easier when you enrolled at Bainbridge High School. There were additional pharaohs that were looking over you and monitoring you called band directors, drama teachers, coaches, club sponsors, ROTC officers, a host of administrators, counselors, resource officers, and even a drug dog with Officer Aiken. They were all called pharaohs. However, you all did realize that there were graduation requirements that had to be met to get you out of bondage. What you experienced was, over the years, your life went from having fun to great demands that were put on you by all of those pharaohs. With your pharaoh parents, you didn't have the freedom to go and come like you wanted to. It seemed like many of your friends had more freedom It is an environment that you have no idea of what is going to happen. For example, those going to college, joining the military, or just joining the workforce, you don't know what type of challenges you are going to be faced with. Whatever the challenges are, you will need a leader who has the answers to every challenge. As a matter of fact, the leader who is the Lord has already planned your future. Your parents will take or send you off to school, to the military, or some other destination. However, they will not be with you every minute of every day. You will need God every step of the way. God didn't send the Israelites into the wilderness. He led them through the wilderness. God led them with a pillar of cloud by day and a pillar of fire by night. He guided them, he covered them, he fed them, and he protected them for 40 years while in the wilderness. The Lord told Moses that his presence will be with his children. Therefore, you will need the Lord's presence to be with you. The purpose of going through the wilderness is for God to test you just like he did the Israelites. God wants to make sure that you will be ready for the promised land. God is going to test your commitment, and he's going to test your character. Remember, we say, character is who and what you are when no one is looking. God had to humble the Israelites himself through hunger and affliction. There were pitfalls and other tests to see what was in the hearts of the Israelites. God is going to allow pitfalls, challenges, and even crises in your life to determine what is in your heart. God wants you to understand that your success in the promised land will depend on what has been sown in your heart. Basically, every surrounding you have, your life can be traced back to what is going on in your heart. If you decide to do nothing with your life, it is in your heart. If you decide to be the most successful professional of all times, it will come from your heart. The word of God must be in your heart. God wanted to know if the Israelites were going to do right about him in spite of their hardships, hunger, and thirst. God wants to know from you, will you remain committed to him when you have challenges at school, at work, or just in your life that is not going in your favor? God wants to know, will you love, trust, honor, and obey him in the wilderness? The Lord said, if you don't trust, obey, and honor him while you're in the wilderness, there is no way you will trust, honor, and obey him in the promised land. The promised land, remember, is a land that is flowing with milk and honey. The Israelites' journey through the wilderness was supposed to be 11 days. It took them 40 years to get to the promised land because they refused to obey God. My question to the class of 2022 is, will it take you 40 years to make it to the promised land? Those students that are going to college for 2 or 4 year degrees, will it take you 40 years to complete your degree or to graduate? Those heading into the military, will it take you 40 years before you move out of the rank of being a private? It all depends on your obedience to God. God brought his people to the wilderness so that they could learn through sacrifices and self-denial with the power to love each other as he loved them. The wilderness is about growth. As you take on new ventures, you must show growth. Through the wilderness and the guidance from God, each of you will become more grown up and self-reliant. Most of all, you will learn how to depend on God to meet your needs. The Israelites had a very hard time embracing God's perfect plan, which was for Moses to lead them out of Egypt through the desert into the promised land in 11 days. God doesn't intend to leave you stuck in the wilderness for 40 years. change the dynamics of everything. Being in the wilderness with God will cause you to mature so that instead of you needing a miracle, you will become the miracle that others will need. This is how Christ lived, and we ought to follow him. Please don't become a wilderness dweller. A wilderness dweller often lives from crisis to crisis, generating endless cycles of problems and needs. They will not commit to finishing anything. They will be wandering through their life from place to place, just like the Israelites, and always being judgmental of others. Wilderness dwellers will quickly inform you about what is wrong with every person you meet. They will also tell you how to fix things. Don't let behaviors such as grumbling, complaining, jealousy, envy, backstabbing, and bitterness keep you in the wilderness. While God is leading you through the wilderness, you will learn life lessons that will help you grow and keep you on the track toward the promised land. There will be storms in your life, but you must recognize that God is more powerful than any storm you will ever face. God's guidance in wilderness is not designed for you to be overwhelmed. It is designed for you to overcome. Don't let pride control your destiny. Don't let your pride separate you from the service of God. You know, the funny thing about pride is that it is almost impossible for some people to recognize that they have. Don't let your pride keep you in the wilderness by making you think you know it all. If you think you know everything, this makes you unteachable. You must be teachable, and you must be willing to be taught. If you only great